rainwater harvesting for a better life. One of the major challenges to rural development, especially in arid and semi-arid areas of Kenya and the Greater Horn of Africa, is how to sustain food production to meet an ever-increasing demand. This situation is worsened by climate change, persistent droughts, and water scarcity. Introduction of modern technologies related to green revolution, such as conventional irrigation systems, has unfortunately not provided a sustainable solution. These systems, though tested and successful in other regions of the world, have not been as successful in many areas in the arid and semi-arid areas. The disruptions of livelihoods, the high level of maintenance and low farmers' capacity means that they are not easily scalable to increase food production. Thus, these regions continue to experience drought, crop failures, livestock death, and under extreme conditions, loss of human lives. The end result is overdependence on relief food. These challenges threaten the stability and existence of these communities because their long-held systems are failing to cope due to ecological challenges, and this has in turn made them vulnerable. Over 60% of land in sub-Saharan Africa is in arid and semi-arid areas, and majority of the people who live in these areas practice pastoralism. These areas are characterized by low and unreliable rainfall, poor or limited sources of water, whose main source is seasonal rivers.
Water is a major asset in terms of food security in Kenya and indeed in sub-Saharan Africa or everywhere worldwide. But what we realize is that there is a lot of water that we lose when it rains. We don't catch that water. So we came in together and said, okay, how do we assist people have that water stored, harvested and stored, and be utilized for the purpose of environment and for the purpose of food security?
Agriculture is a major economic activity for a majority of Kenyans, engaging between 80 to 85% of the population. Agriculture and its related industries are therefore the biggest source of income for a huge chunk of the population. In the arid and semi-arid areas, livestock rearing is in most cases the only economic activity. These pastoral communities move in search of pasture and water for their animals. In Mogotio area of Baringo County in the North Rift of Kenya, this is the norm. Communities here have for a long time faced many challenges.
The places that I'm working, that is in Baringo County, it is a semi-arid area within the country, and it have very little rainfall, that is because it's an arid area. So people experiences just too short rainfall, which are not adequate for domestic and other uses. So most of the part of the year is very dry, and the community are forced to walk long distances to look for water for their animals, and also the production maybe in agricultural site, the crops are not doing very well because of the arid condition.
Baringo County is located in the Rift Valley of Kenya. It has a moderate climate with temperatures ranging from a minimum of 10 degrees centigrade to a maximum of 35 degrees centigrade in different parts. It is in the drier parts of the county that Kenya Rainwater Association, with support from the African Water Facility of the African Development Bank, is working with communities to uplift their livelihoods.
The methods that we are using, we are doing several components. And we are targeting communities and schools. This project has been implemented in three counties. That is Laikipia County, Baringo County, and Kiambu County. All these counties have semi-arid areas. And that's why we thought of venturing into them, because they have water scarcity. So we are doing water harvesting components. In schools, we do also wash, that is water hygiene and sanitation. Because like in schools, we construct 75 cubic meter masonry tanks. We also do farm ponds, and we also construct VIP latrines. That is ventilation improved pit latrines.
Our primary function is actually on rainwater, rainwater harvesting, the rainwater utilization for the purpose of environmental sustainability.
We work with communities which are in water-scarce counties of Kenya, so because water is our entry point for rural development, and how we select them, we sometimes select them directly because they come to us when they know we are working in a neighboring area. They will say, we've heard KRA is working on ABCD and we're also interested. So we normally ask them, you have to be organized or semi-organized. You develop a proposal or tell us in point form, what are the key issues or the key challenges that you are facing? And from your own point of view, how would you want to address them? So that when you're coming in, we build on what they've already decided they want to do, so that we try to empower them to actually achieve their goals. Otherwise, if you go from top down that we want to do ABCD for you, we've seen at times it doesn't work because they always be calling it a KRI project and not their project.
Here at Cheptolil, Kenya Rainwater Association has implemented various projects that seek to harness the potential of rainwater to change the lives of the residents.
Shida ya maji ilikuwa kitu inakera sisi kabisa. Mbeleni, community ya hapa walikuwa wakienda mbali sana. Tuseme sasa kama mtu anaweza kwenda ng'ombe kuanzia asubuhi mpaka jioni, na siku hiyo unaweza kukuta kama ng'ombe hawezi kupata maji siku hiyo, kesho yake unatembea kutafutia maji ng'ombe. So unaenda kitu kama kilomita 15-20. So hapo unaweza kuona kama time nyingi ilikuwa ikipotezwa kwa kuangalia maji, kutafuta maji na kuangalia malisho ya ng'ombe.
Rainwater harvesting is a very important component in the rural areas, because mostly in the rural areas, people lack the piped water systems and other form of water sources. So when you harvest the water from the rain, it is a very good technology for the community, and it helps a lot because you can use that water for domestic micro irrigations and also for animal health.
Tumeanza kukusa hii mambo ya mboga mboga kidogo kwa hapa, na wengine wameanza nyumbani. Nachota maji kutoka damu wengine mtoni, alafu wanaenda weka kwa hiyo tripki kwa nyumbani. Na sasa tunapata mboga nyumbani, tuna shida ya mboga tena. Kazi ingine, tumeanza kupanda hii nini, ndengu. Tunataka ku at least mvua ikikosekana kidogo, tunaanza kuweka kwa hii maji ya damu. Kwa hivyo at least at the end of the year tutapata kitu kidogo ya kutusaidia.
Cheptolil self-help group members have started experiencing the benefits of this water dam that has ensured they have water even during the dry seasons. Before the construction of this water dam, inhabitants of this area used to trek more than 15 kilometers to access seasonal streams or to dig shallow wells by the dry rivers.
Maisha ilikuwa ngumu kweli. Tulikuwa tukisafiri mbali kupata maji. Kwanza wanyama, mang'ombe, mbuzi, tuna travel kupata maji ili wakunywe. Ama kazi ingine tulikuwa na tichimba kisima kwa mto ili tupate maji ya kuchotea. Tunaona hiyo kazi ilikuwa ngumu sana kwa sababu tunaweza chimba kisima na tutapata maji, ama maji itakuwa mbali kidogo, deep sana ili tupate, na tutakuwa tumepoteza wakati kwenda kungojea wanyama kuchotea maji. Hiyo tutapoteza wakati kubwa, lakini saa hii at least tumepata maji kwa karibu. Maji yenye hata ng'ombe akifika peke yake anakuja kunywa na kujiendea. Sasa tunapata nafasi ya kufanya kazi nyingine.
Watu kutoka location nyingine na location nyingine nakuja hapa yote kukunywa hii maji hapa. Ng'ombe karibu zaidi ya 2,000 na kuchanga hapa siku ya kiangazi, na mbuzi karibu zaidi ya 5,000. Sasa anakuja tumia hii maji sauri ya siku ya kiangazi, hakuna maji area hii hata moja, na wananchi wenyewe anakuja kuchota tena, napata ya kusaidia nyumbani.
The project has also passed the water harvesting skills and infrastructure to various schools in the region. These ventilation-improved pit latrines that have been constructed at this primary school in the neighboring village of Kaplelwa have not only improved the quality of life for these pupils, but also improved enrollment in the schools and academic performance.
Wakati tulipata hii choo, wanafunzi waliongezeka. Mbeleni tulikuwa na wanafunzi 106.
All across the county, various primary schools have been given a new lease of life due to continued availability of water at the schools across the school terms. Water that schools in urban areas take for granted is here changing life, helping increase enrollment, and boosting school mean grades in national exams.
Kuhusu results, tangu mwaka huu, tumeona results sasa kutoka classes imeanza kuinuka iende juu. And then class 8, currently, we are now aiming at 300 mean grade. Mbeleni tulikuwa na mean grade ya 250, lakini sahi wako na 280, lakini tunaona tunaweza karibia 300, so our aim is 300.
Okay, imeanza kupanda juu, sababu wanafunzi wameweza kupunguza ule wakati wa kupoteza muda mwingi, na wakatumia kuconcentrate kwa mambo ya darasa. Kwa hivyo tunaona imechangia matokeo yetu. Mbeleni tulikuwa na mean ya 270 na sasa tuko na mean ya 284.
Wakati tuko na shida ya maji, mara kwa mara watoto wanachelewa sababu wa kwenda kutafuta maji kwa mtoni mbali, lakini tukiwa na maji karibu hata usabi ya watoto inakuwa, sababu wanapata maji mzuri ya kuoga, hali ya watoto inakuwa mzuri. So watoto sasa hawatakosa kuenda shule sababu maji iko karibu.
Another project implemented by Kenya Rainwater Association is this water pan. This innovation that has been perfected over time by KRA engineers and technicians is tailor-made to meet the social and climatic conditions of these regions that it has been introduced. This is a life changer here.
Imetusaidia maana unaona hata sisi ni wafugaji. Naona tumepata increment ya wafugaji. Kwenda mtu alikuwa na 10 kwa sababu maji imekuwa karibu. Hiyo wanapata maji kwa ukaribu sasa. Wana sana kwa haraka. Pia tuko na nyuki. Tunapataga asali kwa huwa tunapataga karibu mara moja kwa mwaka, lakini zile iko karibu na maji tunayasafuka asali. Tunayasafuna asali hata karibu mara mbili mara tatu.
Mama wakienda mbali kulete maji, pengine iko mjamzito, pengine hata hiyo mtoto sababu ya hiyo kasi mama anafanya hata kuwa na afya mzuri, na hata wakati itasaliwa itakuwa na unaona watoto wanakuwa na ulemavu fulani. Lakini tunashukuru sasa watu ya KRA sababu maji ikikuwa karibu watoto ya hata wenye watasaliwa itakuwa ni health, sababu maji iko hapa karibu, wamama wachoki kwenda kuleta maji. Watakuwa hata hao watakuwa na afya sababu maji ni uhai.
Kaptai is located in the semi-arid area of Baringo County. It is here at Barsemoi Primary School that KRA has been working to improve water security and introduce vegetable farming through drip irrigation. This project, implemented with support from the Africa Development Bank, has done much in supplementing the government-sponsored school feeding program.
Kuna huu mradi wa Fampon, teknolojia ambayo ni mpya kwetu. Hata kichichi, wana kichichi, wameshangaa sana kuona mradi kama huu. Wanafunzi wakawa na ile interest ya kutaka kujua ni teknolojia la aina gani. Kwa hivyo wakati teknolojia hii ilipo imarishwa, kwa hivyo wanafunzi walipata nafasi ya kujifunza wanapo andaa shamba, wanapo panda, hata kubalilia. Kwa hivyo wanapata kujifunza mambo mengi, wanapata skills mpya, na ile attitude yao ya kufanya kazi shambani ikabadilika.
Kama maji imetusaidia, tumeanza kupanda hapa, tulipanda hapa mboga, tukafuna, tumepanda hii ndengu, sasa tumefuna, tunaelekea kupiga alafu tunakula.
The water we harvest in schools can irrigate a 50 by 100 feet of a piece of land for 6 months. We have seen it being used to improve the school feeding programs. We also train the school pupils on some crop husbandry, because we train them on field management activities like planting, land preparation, weeding, pests and weed control, record keeping, and also various methods of harvesting in schools.
Kenya Rainwater Association has also been working with farmers in the dry areas of Laikipia County to help improve the output from their smallholder farms through the introduction of rainwater harvesting and drip irrigation technologies. At Minora Green Farm, drip irrigation has not only changed the fortunes for Jonathan Jomo, but helped him produce crops all year round to help meet demand.
The first time you are planting, for example, a whole acre at one time, but what we noticed is once you plant and harvest, customers keep asking for products for like the next 3-4 months. So we needed to be consistent. So that's why we had to get the drip irrigation and the dam, so that once we harvest the water, products, at least we can space the products. If it's planting quarter acre, after every 1.5 months or 2 months, so that our customers may be satisfied with what we are doing.
The situation hasn't always been rosy for him. Due to weather changes and the high cost of piped water, Jomo was unable to sustainably continue farming.
The rainfalls have really changed. And in fact, farmers from this area, the last 2 years, they haven't harvested anything. So when we wanted to go commercial, and the customers also wanted to, people who are consistent, so we decided that there needs to be a solution for water. Now there is water that comes from the Abadeas through the, there's a Catholic mission that brings the water, but it is metered water. And the first time we used it was very expensive financially. So we decided to use KRA so that we can be able to harvest consistently water and be able to provide products throughout the whole year.
This technology is also replicated at Ngenya in Laikipia North Sub-County, where a farmer, Jackson Kahiga, has also found great relief and high returns from his small farm where he practices mixed farming.
Nimefuna hii hapa mnaona sehemu hii kidogo na mna hii nilifuna gunia 14. Na nikauza kwa shilingi 3,500. Na sio kwenda kwa soko walikuna kuji hapa. Na ninafikiria hata kilima sehemu kidogo na utuze mzuri inakuwa ni ajabu.
The water stored at this water pan has been his savior during the dry spells that this region experiences most of the year. Despite the greenery seen at this time of the year, this area experiences more than 7 months of drought, totally exhausting most water sources. Residents are forced to walk for hours to the nearest water point that is unreliable.
Wakati kulikuwa kiangazi kubwa, hakuna mbua, hakuna nini. Nilikuwa natumia hiyo pod kwa maji, kwa irrigation, kwa drip.
Just like in other regions where KRA is working, there's a sanitation project aimed at school-going children.
Everywhere you go, there are schools. And why do we select schools? It's because everybody actually has an interest in schools. Either your children are there, you're schooled in those areas, and functions are normally held in schools. When you have county governments or meetings being held, you find most of them public barasas, they select schools. We want somewhere that these people can see the technology. People can look at it and say, yes, this is what we think can work in this area. Again, the kids, we want them to run as early as possible, that this area is not desperate.
I'm very proud for what the Kenya Rainwater Association have done for us, because they have assisted us for many things. We have farm pod there, and we have used it in many ways. We are farming many things, vegetables, and now you are planning to plant trees, and they help our environment. Even now you can look at our environment, you can see it is very clean. We have taken care of it because we have toilet here, we have water, and you are using it well.
Bereni tulikuwa na uhaba wa maji, na sasa tumepata maji. Na washukuru sana. Na pia wametujengea choo na beleni choo ilikuwa haba sana na sasa tumepata vyoo vizuri sana na tunatumia vyema na pia tuko na farm pod mzuri sana tumepanda boga na pia imetusaidia sana na pia tunajaribu kupanda vitu vingine ili tuweze kupata vyakula vizuri.
We thank the Kenya Rain Water Association because we have an increase in the school enrollment. Last year it was roughly 220 and now it is reaching to 300. We also thank the Kenya Rain Water Association because we still have an increase in what we call the school MSS, that is the school MINISCO. We were registered on an increase of 27 MSS.
The head teacher at Tetu Primary School attributes the good things that have come to this school in the recent past to availability of clean and reliable water supply.
The sanitary situation in this school was very pathetic because the petri latrines were collapsing day in, day off, so we had a hectic time trying to reconstruct day in, out. And more so, when they collapsed, the children did not have enough facilities. But on the incoming of the new facility, which we are now available for the girls, they are quite a good number that can cater for the number of girls in the school. They can cater for the number of boys in the school. We have a feeding program in the school. And we used to tell the parents every morning to bring water to the school to have their lunch. So right now we have a big tank, which actually we have harvested enough water that will take us all along through the dry spell, during the dry spell, until we wait for the other line, because it's about 75 cubic meters that can run us all through. More so, the children, after visiting the latrines, they have where to wash their hands, they have clean water to drink. So it's quite a good job, and we are very happy for this project.
Through the funding from Africa Development Bank, KRA has also identified local farmers and farmer groups in the region to help them scale up production, thereby improving their lives and those of their dependents. Here at Umande Shopping Center, we meet Mr. Gesheru, a successful entrepreneur who has changed his life thanks to this farm pond.
Wakati nikuja hapa tulikuwa tunaenda kutafuta maji mali kama huko Akeu, huko Umande, pengine huko Nyareginu. Kwa hivyo sio ati kulikuwa kuzuri, lakini hii mradi wakati iligia, kila mtu anaona kuna mabadiliko. Pia mimi naona kuna mabadiliko. Juu hata ilinisaidia hata nikanunua hii gari. Kwa hivyo niko na mabadiliko mingi hapa. So hawa watu nasema wakae mzuri na wafikirie mahali ingine.
Lack of water in this area led him to install this water pan at the back of his farm that provides him with water for irrigating his kitchen garden, domestic use, and provide him with excess that he sells at this water kiosk.
Nimejenga water kiosk na kwa siku naendelea tu naona kama tunasaidia na wao napata shilingi 20 kwa mtungi mmoja. Unauza kitu kama mitungi 100 kwa siku. Sasa hiyo mradi hata watu wanafurahia sana.
Although we receive very little rain for about 700 millimeters per year, that water is adequate if harvested to grow crops which can go for over 90 days. The thing which is lacking to many farmers is water harvesting technology.
What we do as Kenya Rain Water Association, we may not provide everything that is needed by the community or by the nation. What we do, we only introduce the technology. We do demonstrations. So we work with the government and CBO members so that these projects or this technology can be replicated or can be innovated or adapted by the community members.
Through its engagement with farmers in the dry areas of this region, KRA has been able to turn around the lives of many residents who in the past would have been reliant on relief food during the drought periods.
The company initially when we went there, they were telling us, why are you bringing this kind of things? Are you saying you don't want the relief food to be coming to us? Because to them they are like, if you empower us, then you are cutting out the relief food. I told them you should be ashamed talking about relief food because we want to see a country where nobody is getting relief food. And I give them my example from Israel, which is an Acadia desert. And this is a country that's actually providing relief food or development to other countries.
Schools in the neighboring village of Nyarigino have also had water tanks, water points, and improved ventilated toilets constructed through the project.
I was inspired by the farm pond, which was constructed in school, and I've also done it at least at home, which I'm enjoying at this particular time. There are sales that currently I'm selling, and I'm getting benefits from the small farm that I'm dealing with.
Njumbi, a small village in Kiambu West sub-county, has also experienced the benefits of rainwater harvesting. Though Kiambu County is generally classified as a water-secure region due to abundance of rivers and streams, this semi-arid area is on the leeward side of the Ngong Hills and it experiences dry spells, especially in the months of August to January. Farmers in this region who are reliant on rain to plant their crops have over the years suffered when rains delayed, leading to crop failure. With the introduction of rainwater harvesting, farmers in the Ndeya area have not only experienced the freedom that comes with the reliable water supply, but propel them to transition from subsistence to commercial farming.
It has changed our life as a community because first of all, we realized, KRA made us realize that we can intervene in nature. Because you see, we used to depend on natural elements. When it rains, we have a crop. Once it dries up, we don't have anything. But by the KRA introducing the water pans, we realized that we can conserve water during the rain. And then once it starts drying up, we would be able to raise a crop. And we were informed that with the water from the water pan, we would be able to cultivate at least an eighth of an acre for 3 months and grow a crop that would raise money for you. Farming must take a new turn, not the old tradition of farming. We must do it as a business. That is ensuring that we have seen how much money we have put in, and the ways to make sure that you get a yield out of that. And you do your sums to see whether what you have put in is making a profit or is not making a profit.
With the improved water supply and sanitation component, Njumbi Primary School, located in Ndeya Karai sub-location, has also benefited with the construction of a farm pond, masonry water storage tank, and improved latrines.
Our latrines were pathetic. They were few in number, and then they were in very bad condition. Some were getting filled up, and even we had a verbal warning from the health department that they were going to close down our school. Planners used to waste a lot of time queuing when you release them. After parade at around 8:15, they would stay in the toilet close to half an hour queuing. But these days, now that the toilet rooms are enough, they are able to use the facility very quickly and get to class. So they have saved a lot of time. We had a very small plastic water tank, which was not enough. We have got about 400 pupils in this school. The small water tank, plastic one, was not enough. And that was the situation. We needed water for washing our rooms, our classrooms, and the toilets. Children used to ferry water from home. Children no longer carry water from home. They use the water from the tank for drinking, for washing after toilets, for washing their classrooms, for washing all the corridors, for all the water uses that we require in the school.
It's an integrated approach whereby you're not just giving or engaging the farmers or the community in terms of rainwater harvesting, but also promoting the supplementary technologies like setting up of the vegetable gardens, the issue of planting trees and setting the seedlings for the community and also for the various schools. Other than just the farmers, we'd really also appreciate the good work of KRA in terms of promoting sanitary activities within the schools, because it goes along in improving the sanitation and also the health issues, and also the production of food to supplement the lunch programs.
Due to climate change and challenges associated with it in the region, efforts to foster water security and adaptive capacity are extremely important. These projects, implemented by Kenya Rainwater Association with support from the African Development Bank, will ensure that communities in these regions experience better sanitation, promote small-scale irrigation, and thereby improve the well-being of people in these areas.
Kenya depends on agriculture. Agriculture is said to be the backbone of our economy. And so, when the African Development Bank funds activities to do with agriculture, it is actually helping the country to improve. Because in as much as we are building towns and so on, the people living in these stone houses have to eat. And so when the African Development Bank funds agriculture, it is helping the country feed itself and also earn revenue. I want to say, you know, in praise of Kenya Rainwater Association, it has hit on a very convenient way of using this money. Because once we have dug in the ground, the land is still yours and you're still using it, and the water is just flowing in. And it is a conservation. You have the rain and it just flows away, but the water that is contained there is going to help us as a community to mitigate when there is a drought. Because when other people don't have the water, we have that water preserved there, and we shall use it especially around August, September, December, when in this region it is a dry season. And when we grow our cash crop, we have a market for it in December and January when it is dry.
There should be more collaborations. The policymakers, like the legislators in this country, should come up with water harvesting policies. Like come up with a rule that every building that should be put up, whether it's in an urban area or in a rural area, should have a rainwater harvesting component in it. And all stakeholders should collaborate to make sure that rainwater harvesting is inculcated in the culture of the communities in Kenya.
We have demonstrated that technology works. Now is scaling up. How do we attract investments? And investments now is not through community service, because what we'll be doing is community service. We get money from donor A, we implement, and it ends there. And we cannot reach the scale. So we are now actually thinking, how do we bring in microfinances? How do we bring farmers to actually take loan? Because we have demonstrated to them, if you adopt this technology, within 2-3 seasons, you're able to repay. And that's now we are now moving towards making sure that we can promote this technology as a business enterprise rather than community service. And we are actually thinking, even as an organization, we are starting a social enterprise arm, which will be promoting that now as a business wing, because we have the staff and we have the technology. It's a matter of now, who do we partner with? Two, we're also looking at the other counties we have not been. We don't have to always rely on getting somebody out there to come and support us. What we've seen, we only need to convince the farmers, and we have evidence to show that, and the impacts are clear, that you can actually invest in this business and move on.
With these innovations and their relevance to the smallholder farmer, there is hope that more farmers will reap from the benefits that come with rainwater harvesting.